Hello, hello, crafty peeps. Welcome back to my channel, Crafty-ish Kristen. Today we're going to be working on Van Gogh Never Leveled Up. This is my cross stitch conversion project that I started in January, and I got a little sidetracked, but I want to work on it, number one, because I want to be done with the project, and I actually really would like the storage case back. I just noticed I am missing some drills. These art dot drills were not sitting as flush together as I would like. And this was kind of like folded up. So I mean, really, I'm not surprised that there is a missing drill. I do see some other ones that need to be pushed down, but we're not gonna worry about that right now because we're just going to worry about doing a section. I wanted to show you guys how it's looking before we get started, and here is the picture of what it will look like. I split it into two panels. So this is panel number one, and this is panel number two. And it's only going to be about, where is my notes? I had notes. It's been so long since I've even pulled this out. It's going to be about, where is my thing? I think it's going to be like 50 by 50 centimeters total, because it's 200 stitches by 200 stitches. Yes, so 200 stitches divided by 4 is 50, so 50 centimeters. So yeah, that is what we are going to be working on today. So as you can see in my little tracker I made, this is where we are, and that is still all we need to do. But before I do that, I am going to open up a little piece of happy mail that I received for my birthday. Oh, I'm a little close. Hopefully it's not too, maybe I can unzoom. I'm gonna unzoom. Oh, please don't screw everything up. Okay, that's as good as it's gonna get. Don't watch me use these giant like kitchen shears, because it's a little dangerous looking, guys. So I hope everybody is doing well. Oh, I have help. Thank you, Duncan. Can you move away from the scissors so I don't accidentally cut you? I don't want to go to the emergency vet on a weekend. That sounds awful. I mean, going to the vet any day sounds awful, but still. So this is from Diamond Painting with Jack. She said she was sending me a card, and then it was like the post office was telling me I had an actual package, and I was like, oh, okay. I was expecting a card. That's okay. Okay. Oh my gosh. Okay. I should have done that off camera, but that's me. I'm going to look at the card just because, in case there's anything like embarrassing or naughty written in there. Okay, good. It's not. She did. I won't say what she said in her message, but it was funny. So look at that cute card. So cute. Thank you. Thank you. Oh my gosh. Okay. Let me just have the cutest little Hello Kitty. I don't want to mangle Hello Kitty. And cute. I'm going to end up spilling my Dr. Pepper all over. That is not good. All right, Duncan, you want to help me? No, he's just going to stare at me. Oh my gosh. So Dr. Pepper keeps. So funny story, somebody posted on my Facebook group about like, it was like a picture full of all these Dr. Pepper flavored food things. And I had said, yeah, I bought the Peeps, but they were kind of weird. So I didn't eat them. Well, I kept eating them, guys. Every time I would go in the kitchen, I would eat one and I'd be like, oh man, this tastes weird. This texture is weird. But yeah, I ate the whole box of Peeps. So clearly I did like them. So that is too funny. Okay, you need to get away from my belongings. Thank you. Thank you, Duncan. Oh, look at the little Harry Potter. Oh my gosh. How cute. It's a little Harry Potter sticker. Oh no, it's a bunch of them. Oh, it's a bunch of them. Oh, it's all of those. Oh my gosh, that is too cute. That is too cute. Okay, Kat's trying to unwrap the tissue paper over there. Okay. Oh my gosh, dark chocolate covered honey grams and sea salt. Yes, because I love chocolate and I love sea salt. It's one of those things, when it first came out, I was like, Why would you put salt on something? I totally get it now. I totally get it. And, okay. Could I get the stuff out of the box before you claim it as your own? Thank you. Oh, okay. Okay, well, once again, Duncan just has to ruin everything. See, pardon me. And it's a Starbucks cup. So, huge, huge thank yous. That was so unexpected. And I also got a sweet handwritten note from Patricia. I won't show that, but, you know, that was really sweet too. I appreciate. Oh, sorry. Okay. I'm going to move the box so he can, oh my gosh, go over there. Okay. Well, that was a mess and it's still a mess. Great. Okay. I am going to pause you guys. I'm going to get situated. I got to put something heavy on this canvas. Otherwise, we're going to be sliding around the whole time. So I will be right back. Okay. I am as situated as I am going to get today. So, and I will go over my supplies. So I am using B's Crafty Corner release papers. And this is the Pippy release papers that I just did a giveaway with on my last Whip and Chatty rant. And there is a explanation in the description box of how, if you want to order your own, you can. You basically will just go to B's Crafty Corner on Etsy and use the custom link. Hang on, let me look at, I should probably be diamond painting while I'm yapping. Use the custom link and then in the description box, or you know, the little notes box or whatever, you can say Pippy release papers and she has it saved. And you can do it that way. 1, 2, 3, 4. It was kind of cool though, because I did have, I had a winner for the release paper giveaway in the UK, one in Australia, and one in the US. So we were covering lots of ground. Okay, that's why I don't put that there, because I can't get my pen there. Yes. So I am using glue dots in this pen, but these art dot drills are very dirty and dusty. And so I have to change the glue dot fairly often, which if you've used glue dots, you know that you can use the glue dot for, like, the same glue dot for a very long while. That just shows how dirty these drills are. Okay, I'm trying to multi-place, but this is not the best tray for multi-placing. So I am only going to do a, or even attempt to try to do a 2x3 section, and I probably will not finish that because I'm a little out of practice and I don't really want to hold you guys hostage all day long. Let's see, what else? This is a Bella Art Dana Cole tray. I don't know what the name or the style name of the tray is, but I do like it. I like that the little spout thing is on top. I feel like it is, I don't know, you know, something different, but they don't have big trays with the spout on top, which I was a little bummed about. And they didn't have very many colors. So I don't know if this is a tray that's like discontinued. I don't really know. Or it's just not a popular one, but it's a good size if you're doing like special drills or just a small painting or a confetti heavy painting like this one is. Oops, there's an extra diamond. I don't have my trash lid out. So if I have trash, I'm just going to throw it to the side. What? Let's see, there's only three for that one. So I've been hesitating to work on this one. So every time I see it, I'm like, I don't want to. I don't want to. But then I was like, you know what? You just got to get over yourself, girl. Just do it. Because no one else is going to finish it for me. No one else. Shockingly. Since no one else in my family really likes diamond paint, and especially take on a crazy project like this. And I've been, you know, enjoying my just regular diamond paintings. Those are my favorite, I will say. I mean, the conversion is kind of fun. My cat is trying to steal the tissue paper on the table. But I will say, there is something more relaxing about just sitting down and working on a regular diamond painting and then just kind of letting your brain, you know, wander off where it wants to go and not really having to overthink everything. Because with this, you definitely gotta use the noggin. Which is a good thing, but, you know, by the end of the day, I do not have the mental capacity to do this, that is for sure. Okay, that one right there. So hopefully I don't mess up on the first color like the last time I worked on a conversion project. Yeah. Wait, no. Nope. Nope. One more. Okay. And this glue definitely is a little tackier. Like, I don't know. I think I said before, it almost feels puffy. Like it's thicker. It has more substance to it. It's definitely not as slidey as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. As you know, I guess a different kind of, you know, canvas glue. And I don't know if that's just, you know, how heaven and earth canvases are, or if it's just me. That one is super crooked. Whoa. Oh my gosh, seriously. Go in there. Okay, then we have 1, 2, 3. Okay. So. There we go. I screwed up. See? Look at that. Luckily, I did catch it in time, but I put those on the third one instead of the second down. Yep. That's probably another reason why I'm like, I don't want to work on that, because I know I'm going to screw it up, guys. I know I am. Okay, these two. Oh, that is definitely sticky, though. The fact that I have diamonds missing off this canvas is shocking, because it is very sticky. So 1, 2, and then 1, 2. Wait. What? No. 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 Yes. No. Yes. No. Yes. No. Nope. Okay. Come on. Go over one. Okay. Whew. Let's see. Well, there's 4. So then we go up 2. And I did draw the lines in on this canvas. I bolded the 10 lines, because they did not show up to me as obvious as I would like. And in theory, if the diamonds cover properly, then you shouldn't see those pink lines. But I did look at it from straight down, and I can see the pink in between some of the colors. But, you know, it is what it is. Oops, here's a blue right there. Oh, there's another blue. So I think I need to, there's like a fold right here. I think I need to, I probably need to take the whole plastic off and rip it off. But I'm not doing that right now. Okay, what color do we want to do next? Oh, number 25. Okay, so number 25 is actually not 25, because there's no DMC 25 in diamond painting, so I substituted it for 762. And because there's only 2 in this section. I just put a few in the lid and do it that way. I would try to stick my pen into the container, but I have a feeling that would just potentially make me spill them all over. And I really don't want to spill them all over. So, nope, I need to mark them off. Nope, what? I marked them off. Good job. Good job, me. Good job. All right, we will do, it's 9:31. And this has, I think it's 96 colors. If I remember correctly, which I might not be remembering, or maybe it's 90. Actually, no, I think it's 90. It's on the sheet. I could look at it, but it's way over there on the table. So that's not going to happen because I can't reach it. oh, geez. Okay. Can't use the multiplacer end up there by the tippy top. Oh, see? And I'm, I keep shifting, but I'm not trying to. I put my husband's work computer on top of the canvas to hopefully hold it still. Hopefully he doesn't have to come down here and use it. Otherwise, I'm going to be like, you can't take that because I'm using it. So, yeah, my son, I swear, he has the worst luck with computer chargers. So, I had to buy a new computer because his computer got bit by the cat. And yes, it got bit. The cat bit the corner of the screen and the screen, like, you know, the what is it, the LED, whatever, the screen is like glitching and making weird lines and stuff. Well, we kept meaning to switch it over because I'm like, okay, I have my new computer, I have everything switched over, okay, now we can do it. Well, we keep putting it off and he stopped complaining about the glitching, and I was like, well, maybe we should just wait then, because he's not very gentle on the electronics. So, oh wait, what is that? What the heck is that? I think that's just an extra that fell on. I don't know. We're just gonna just put it over here for now. And so I was like, maybe we should wait because he's very rough. Like, he'll be playing, you know, VR games and he'll have his computer open because he has like a group chat with his friends going. And so he wants to be able to hear things and like talking to other people who aren't in the, I don't know. But he'll be swatting the VR headset, you know, remote thingy mabobbers around, and he tends to hit things with them. And he has had to replace one of the handset thingies, one of them already, because he broke it, because he hit something with it. But he says the cat knocked his computer off his desk, and then it landed on the end of the computer where, you know, the charging port was. And of course it was plugged in because it's always plugged in. And yeah, I was like, was it really on your desk though? Cause it's never on his desk. He balances it like on his bed, or I've come in and the computer is on the floor open and he's virtual realitying around it. And I'm like, oh, hell no, dude, come on. Like, you gotta be a little more responsible than that. Please, please, please. Because, I mean, it's not, granted, his laptop's like 4 years old, you know, but still, it's still like a, you know, an Apple laptop. And so it's not cheap to replace by any means. And so he's like, no, the cat got on my desk and he knocked it over. And I didn't realize he knocked it over. And I'm like, yeah, that wasn't the cat, but okay. But so the cat knocked it over and jammed the end that you plug into the computer, jammed it and like shoved it to the side so hard that it basically almost snapped off in the end of the computer. I'm like, good God, man. And he's like, well, I need a computer charger. And I'm like, dude, I'm like, my new computer has a different charging end. And I was like, I guess you can use my old one, you know, the one that he was going to replace his computer with, but we're waiting until he basically breaks this one. And he's like, no, that's this one. I'm like, what do you mean it's this one? Well, he had broken one before
because he dropped it or, you know, slammed it against something. So he had already stolen my computer charger. So I was like, I don't know, you know, I really don't know. I had another one cord left in my office for the computer that he's using. And I was like, this is it. So if you break this one, you know, we're out of luck. So I did order a new one from Amazon because, you know, he does all of his work on his computer for school. And I'm not about to let him borrow my laptop. No, thank you. Not with how rough he is on his electronics. As I said, if you break that one, you're spending your own money to replace it. I am not spending money because you can't control yourself when you're, you know, playing Gorilla Tag or whatever online things you're doing. But yeah. Ugh. It's always something, man. It's always something. But he's already got, I swear, kids already have birthday lists and their birthdays are in May. And I'm like, yeah, I'm not worrying about that right now. That's when I say, and what did you get me for my birthday that's next week? Like, yeah, exactly. It's like, I'm not going to make a fuss about your birthday quite yet, because I'm pretty sure you're not going to get me anything, which I don't care. I would rather my kids make me something, you know, than try to go out and buy, you know, something. Okay, you need to stop, Cat. He is in a mood. So he's been all weird, the cat, because my son had his procedure done and, you know, he came home and he smells like probably like hospital and, you know, who knows what. And so the cat's been very clingy with him, sleeping on his lap. As soon as he gets up, he looks and he kind of follows him. And then, you know, he goes and sits back down and he jumps instantly on his lap and kind of glares at Sharky like, this is my human. Don't you dare come over here. It's like, okay, dude. He's in protective mode. What a sweetie. But then he decides to be a little jackface in the middle of the night. So he's not that sweet. I don't know why cats feel the need to be naughty in the middle of the night. It's like they know you're trying to sleep. And they're like, this is a perfect time to jump on top of a bookcase and knock things off. Or scratching at the closet door or whatever else they feel they need to do to, I don't know. It's like, are they just checking to make sure we're alive? And so they decide to be naughty? I don't know. Okay. Let's hope I'm still doing it right. You guys can't see my pattern keeper screen, so you can't tell me if I'm doing it right or not. So I always struggle with finding the right angle for these videos because it's like, I don't know. Do you guys want to see like the pattern keeper screen and the diamond painting area? Or just the diamond painting area? Or like, do you even care because you're not watching the screen because you're doing your own stuff? I never know. So I just do what I think kind of looks good. And because if I spend too much time overthinking it, then I gotta move my diamonds. Or like, there we go. Okay, they're in my way. Yeah, then I would never do anything because I would just be sitting there overthinking everything, as one does. Okay. I am getting close to the end of my latest batch of stickers. So, and I'm not sure if I'm going to order more of them because I want to make a different sticker. So if you have not filled out the Google Doc to get your own Pippy the Crafty Peep sticker, like right here, then you should do so before they are no more. I mean, granted, I own the, like, it's my image, so technically I could print them whenever I want. But still, I don't want to have, like, a giant stack of 200 stickers and then, you know, them just sit there. So yeah. Oopsie. Why aren't you sticking? You go down there. You go down there. Okay, so this glue dot is atrocious. This actually may be nanotape because it's really, like, I would not put that much glue dot in because they're so tiny that it would take so many extra glue dots to get them in. So this is probably the nanotape one. I think I was experimenting with a few different pen adhesives because of just the fact that I think I did even try the alien putty, and the alien putty, like, it just, it died instantly because there was so much stuff on the drills. It's really weird. And I noticed that when I was, you know, unbagging all of the art dot drills, I noticed that they were very dusty. A lot of the colors were. And I did not think to clean them, because that would have been the smart thing to do before you put them in the bottles. So, and, you know, people were like, why don't you just clean them now? It's like, if I take these diamonds out of the bottles, I'm not going to put them back in. I'm going to be like, nope, I'm done. So it is just something I'm going to have to suffer through and call it good. And I'm making, because, you know, injured kid, they get to choose what to eat. So making corned beef. Because he wanted corned beef for dinner tonight. I'm like, oh, it's not my favorite by any means. And I did not make it for St. Patrick's Day just because I had a feeling he would want it after his surgery. So, yeah, that's what's for dinner tonight. So, yippee. I can't. Oh, the whole house. It makes the whole house smell. And I don't know, I've tried eating it a few times and just, I don't know if it's just the taste or the saltiness of it, or I don't know what it is, but oof. I mean, just the smell, and it makes me instantly think of cat food. I'm like, I can't eat that because it makes me think of cat food. And then one time I had an open can of cat food and I had a thing of corned beef, and I was like, here. To a few family members, and I won't name names, but at least one of them got it wrong of which one was cat food and which one was corned beef. So no thank you. I would rather eat a peanut butter and jelly sandwich or a frozen entree. Actually, I get these one frozen dinners from Trader Joe's for instances just like this, and I really like it. I think it's called like a green chili or green verde chili chicken bowl. It's basically like a green salsa sauce with chicken, and I think it's beans and rice. It may just be rice. And then there might be like some cut up onions or something, but you know, that's not very substantial by any means, which is fine because I don't feel like the vegetables really add that much to it. And I think there's cheese in it too, but it is like my favoriteest frozen entree. And for a while I could not find it at our Trader Joe's. Every time I went, they would not have it. And Trader Joe's is so annoying because they do that thing where if they're out of stock of something, they don't just leave the shelf empty. They move all the other products and close the opening and they take the tag off, which I'm like, why? Don't, because then when I go and I'm looking for something that I know they had, you know, a week or two before, then I'm like, well, what's going on? Where is it? Did they discontinue it? Because a lot of times they discontinue crap that you like too. So then I have to find an employee and ask, and then they'll be like, oh no, we just don't have any in stock. And I'm like, why? Just leave the little empty space or put a little note that says, I'll be back in stock soon or something. Just don't make me feel like I'm losing my mind by closing the spot up on the shelf. And I feel like that just creates more work for the employees, because then you got to take the sticker off. Then the next time when you stock the shelves, when the order comes in, then you got to put the sticker back on and move the other products away. Like, I don't know. But maybe that's just me, like, using my common sense lazy brain. But I would be annoyed if I worked there and people were constantly asking me, do you have this anymore? Did you discontinue it? When it's just, no, we just didn't get any. But again, that's just me. So I also like they have a Hatch chili mac and cheese that is really good. And that's frozen as well. And what else? They have quite a few different, what do you call it? It's like frozen entrees and definitely like a bunch of different, you know, styles of food. Like, you know, they have like the Indian food, and then they have, you know, like more like, you know, kind of like Chinese food. And I think they even have some kind of Greek stuff as well. And then they have, you know, burrito bowls and all that kind of stuff. So I like it. I mean, they're not amazing, and they're not like, you know, a giant meal by any means, but for someone like me who just doesn't want to, you know, cook a second meal after I've cooked a giant first meal, it's pretty good. I dig it. But I do like Trader Joe's because they do have some interesting snacks sometimes, or, you know, different seasonings or seasonal foods, which my mom and my son both love the iced gingerbread men cookies. Oh, sorry, they're not gingerbread men anymore. They're gingerbread people. So don't want to get myself in trouble. I don't want to misgender the cookies, because they're cookies, but like, why? Why can't they just be cookies? I don't understand. But I'm old, so I don't know. Okay, where is that? There is that. We got those. We got the dark blues going in. This half of the canvas is very blue, and it is very confetti heavy, which, you know, makes sense because there is a lot of detail, but there are definitely parts where I'm like, I don't think you needed to have that many colors. But again, it's, I didn't design the pattern. I didn't make the artwork, so I'm just the idiot who chose the pattern. All right. Because there is not a lot of sections in this section, at least, that are, there's one, like, little teepee-looking triangle area that is, I might be able to use my multiplacer. I need to flatten this canvas because that's gonna bug me. Having a big ol' humpity hump. Makes me think of that song, The Humpty Dance. That just makes me sound even older, dear God. Yep. But I was the MTV generation. I remember, like, sitting and watching MTV. Like, that's how I decided what kind of music I wanted to listen to, was, like, I listened to what MTV told me to. Like, oh, this is popular. I guess this is what I should be listening to because that's what they're making music videos for. Where did my diamond go? Is it already losing its stick? Oh my gosh, please no. Please no. If I have to change the adhesive in this pen, then the video's over because I don't even know where the nanotape is. I think it's somewhere in my messy desk area. But that is not on the agenda today. The agenda today is washing laundry. Woo! And changing sheets and blankets. Making corned beef. Probably doing someone's bidding. Because, you know, getting Easter stuff ready. I have to make an Easter menu because my sister-in-law and her boyfriend, well, maybe her boyfriend might have to work, but they're coming over for Easter dinner, and she's like, what should I bring? And I'm like, oh god, that's next weekend, isn't it? Oh, I don't know. Because, I mean, I know in theory that I have a ham, so I am making ham, and then I normally make macaroni and cheese. For selfish reasons, number one, because I love macaroni and cheese, and especially homemade macaroni and cheese when I know what the ingredients are. Because if a homemade macaroni and cheese has a lot of milk, like regular milk, or like heavy cream or something, then I can't really eat it because it'll make my tum-tum feel not magical. Same with my husband. He cannot do regular milk. Like, it just, if he gets milked, he had the unfortunateness of going to a smoothie place with people from work, and he asked them, he said, you know, do you have milk alternatives? And they said yes, this one. So you can see how dirty that bottle is, like the dust. Look at my finger, how dusty it is. And now I'm just spilling diamonds all over. That was worth it. He asked the smoothie place. He's like, you know, do you have, you know, almond milk, soy milk, literally any other milk besides cow milk? And they were like, yeah. We can do almond milk. So he's like, okay. So he got himself a smoothie. Yeah. He goes, we got there. We sat there for maybe like 15 minutes and I was drinking it. And we're riding in the car, and he's like, yeah, I could tell instantly that was not almond milk. I was like, oh. So, yeah, I'm not about to do that on Easter to a loved one or myself, because I'm not that sensitive. Like, I could have drank a smoothie that had regular milk in it, but, I mean, it wouldn't have been comfortable, but it would not have been urgent. So, yeah. So I always have to make sure that if I'm making macaroni that I could probably use like half and half a little bit, but then I always make sure I use almond milk and, you know, substitute, because we can have sour cream. So instead of like the heavy cream or whatever. So most recipes are fairly customizable. I have like three recipes that I kind of, I don't know, mix together depending on, you know, what ingredients I have and whatnot. Because it's all basically the same. I mean, you have your pasta, you have your cheese, whatever that cheese, you know, type maybe. I like to use sharp cheddar. That's just me. And then depending on who's going to be around, sometimes I will make buffalo chicken mac and cheese. And so then you kind of put like in the middle, you put a layer of, like, I usually use rotisserie chicken just because I'm lazy. And then you kind of cook it with like some really fine chopped up onions and celery. And like with some buffalo sauce. And then you kind of put like a thin layer in between two layers of the mac and cheese. So good. So, so good. And sometimes I'll just do that on half the macaroni just because, you know, sometimes my daughter is not in the mood for spicy. And it's not even really spicy, but, you know, it's just, and my mom too. So it's just easier to potentially cut out something that might be a source of complaint, if at all possible. So I know we're doing that. And then I'm like, what the heck else am I supposed to make? I don't know. It's like, that's all I care about is the ham and the macaroni. So, I mean, you probably need a salad, even though half the people won't eat the salad, but you still have to have it as a vegetable. Depending what I can find at the grocery store, I could do like some squash, or I could do some Brussels sprouts. But if I do Brussels sprouts, then I kind of got to cook them in bacon to make them, you know, taste better, at least to me. And obviously you need rolls because you need a bread product. That is always a necessity. And then I was trying to figure out, like, what should I make for dessert? Because last year, what did I make last year? I think I made cranberry bliss bars last year, but I made them too thick, so they were very doughy. And some people don't like cream cheese, you know, frosting, which I get. I normally don't like cream cheese frosting, but on the cranberry bliss bars, it works. So I was thinking I might make like a lemon cake or something. And the humor is not lost on me that I will be probably making Easter dessert on my actual birthday. Like, that seems stupid, but you know, I'd rather home make a dessert than like, you know, buy like a sheet cake from Safeway. Cause I just, it's not, there's anything wrong with it. I don't really like cake in general. So I would rather make something for dessert that I actually want to eat. Because that's usually my number one goal when I make dessert is, do I want to eat this? I mean, unless it's for someone else's birthday and they really, 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 really want something. But yeah, if I think it sounds gross, I'm not going to make it. And then I don't know about anybody else, but I always struggle with, okay, am I supposed to put, like, do I put appetizers out? You know, like, I mean, granted, it's literally just going to be me, two kids, husband, my mom, and then my husband's sister, and maybe her boyfriend. So do I spend a bunch of time and energy, like, cutting up meat and cheese and crackers and, like, getting olives and pickles? And, but then I'm like, but then are they, is people going to eat dinner? Because if everybody's going to fill up on, you know, crackers and meat, like, why the heck am I cooking? I don't want to slave all day in front of a hot stove. Cat's getting a little feisty in the kitchen. Only for people to just eat a bunch of potato chips and crackers and then be like, oh man, I'm just so full. Like, no. No. Okay, there's that. Oh, wait a minute. Nope, I did it right. I did it right still. I haven't screwed up too bad yet. Well, you can't actually see my screen, so I could have screwed up, and I'm just not letting you guys know. But I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't lie to you. If I screw up, you're gonna know. Because I'll tell you. Because sharing is caring. Okay, I did that. Did I do that one? Yeah, I did. Oh, I did mark it off. Look at me. I'm marking stuff off. Go me. Go me. Could you not play with that mouse right next to me, please? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. These are so crooked. Oh my gosh. And on this particular style of canvas, they don't slide as nicely, but it is poured glue, so I don't know. I don't think I could do double-sided adhesive. I really don't, because I am a slider. Just ignore that noise. It's just Duncan. Oh my gosh. I will tell you what, I have never had a cat that can throw a toy for themselves like he can. He picks it up with his claw, like, and he just hooks it in just the right way, and he just flicks it across the room. I mean, it's downright impressive, I gotta say. He can get it. Oh my gosh, this one, why? Just slide. Just freaking go. Seriously. He can get it on top of the bookcase if he is so determined to do it. And then, of course, oh no, I have to get up there and get it, Mom. It's like, no, no, you don't need to be crawling on top of the bookcase, please. But yeah, I've never had a cat that can chuck a toy as far as this cat can. And his brother, he has no desire. He just kind of bats at the toy and plays with it. But I mean, Duncan, I honestly think he could be, if he actually went outside, that he may actually be able to kill something, like a bird or something, which I don't really want him to do. So, you know, he's not going outside because they do not have their outside shots. And we do not live somewhere where it's really, I don't think it would really be the safest to go outside. We live off of a very busy road, and he is kind of stupid. So I don't know if he would know to, you know, not walk into traffic. I would hope not, but I mean, he walks right in front of me when I got like a hot cup of coffee, so I don't know if he would move out of the way for a, you know, a car or know to, you know, run away from the dog across the street, which I love the dog across the street. I don't know what kind of dog he is, guys, but he just, I don't know. He kind of looks, I don't think he's a German Shepherd, but he kind of has like the German Shepherd-ish coloring of the brown and the black. But he just, oh man, he's out there. And if you, you know, you like we pull out of our driveway and there, you know, there's like a busy road and then their house is right across from ours. And he's always laying out there. And as soon as he sees the car approach the driveway, he gets on alert and he's just ready to chase your car as soon as you start driving. And I always feel bad when I, because normally 99% of the time we turn one way, but every once in a while we turn that other way. And it totally throws him off because he instantly, you know, goes to the right. Because that's what, you know, most people, whoa, just throw the pen, dummy. That's what we normally do, is we go to the right. And so he just chases the car, and it's just like an epic, you know, race to the fence line where he has. And he has pushed all this dirt that's right at the end of their fence. He's made this huge mound of dirt where he just runs and slides. I don't know what his name is, but I just call him my little pepperoni. I'm like, you did it, pepperoni, you did it, you got me. And sometimes I'll slow down a little, just so he, you know, just so he feels like extra good about winning. But my husband, he like floors it, because he's like, ha, you didn't catch me. So yeah. We're simple people, okay? That's my excitement for the day sometimes, is when I leave to go pick up kids. I'm like, oh, the dog's out, he chased me. Wait, did I not get that one? Please tell me I got that one. I'm missing one, right? No, I did. I just didn't mark it. Oh dear. I didn't mark it. It's fine. Oh my God, get down. No. He's gonna break stuff. Oh my God. Oh, you turd, get down. Oh my gosh. Duncan. Oh, you are in so freaking much trouble. Get down. Get! Oh my gosh! No! No! Oh! God, dude! Seriously!
tormenting you, you big butthead. Well, don't come for me and say you don't like it when I yell at my cats, because he seriously jumped up on top of the bookcase and like on top of all the Pyrex. So, no, you're on my list right now. You're on my list. He doesn't care. He could care less. What time is it? Oh. Goodness. He is on. No, thank you. I don't need you to help me. Okay. I think this will be my last color. Because now I'm all feisty. And I gotta put another load of clothes in. And finish my Easter menu. Do all the things. Ugh. So. Get away from my doctor. Yeah, get away from my Dr. Pepper, please. Yeah, no, I can tell these are dirty because it's not picking up anymore. Seriously, come on, dude, work with me. Hang on, let me stab my glue dot with the tweezers to try to revitalize it for just a little bit. Come on, you can pick it up. You can do it, little friend. Good job. Well, I accidentally ordered some diamond painting canvases yesterday. I told myself I wasn't going to, okay? I did. I told myself that. Because I wanted to get my canvas from the company that I ordered before I ordered more, just to make sure, you know, that they're good quality, you know, blah, 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 all the stuff, right? Yeah, no. I had a weak moment. So, they were having a I just touched my face on the camera, sorry. A buy three, get two free sale. And I was like, well, that's a good deal, right? So, I had to use the girl math logic. I'm like, well, you buy more and you save more, right? Makes sense to me. So yeah. So Art and Soul is having a buy three, get two free. I think they said through the end of the month. So the end of March, I believe. So hopefully I get my Care Bear canvas soon. It has not shipped yet. So I don't know. I know it comes, you know, from overseas, which a lot of the, you know, smaller companies, they have to do that. They can't have a giant warehouse stock, you know? And if they have so many different kinds of canvases, then it makes sense that, you know, if you get to pick your size and if you want round or square and you want AB drills. And they also have on some of their canvases, they have, what do they call them? So, I think they call them soul dust or soul drills, which is like, you know, the fairy dust drills from Diamond Art Club. So sometimes they have that offer, which, yay, because if I can get some extra sparkle without having to place ABs, then it is a good day for me. So I did order, a few extra canvases. So I have to stop. I can't keep ordering things. I say that. I was really good in February, I think. Was I good in February? Yeah. I think all I ordered was the Bella Art Nicole canvas, which, hang on, I'll get back to that. And then I ordered the Jade Gem Shop and stupid drills. I honestly don't ever want to use these art dot drills ever again. They piss me off. I ordered the Jade Gem Shop and then I did order from, what's it called? The one with the diamond art. I ordered a few from them. And then I ordered from Art and Soul again. So, oh no, I did order from Art and Soul in, I think it may have actually been the beginning of March. So yeah, I need to slow my roll. I mean, you know, it is what it is. So, and
I was hoping to get my replacement canvas from from Bella Art, and it's not their fault. Totally, this is probably the post office. So it got sent, right? And I'm like, yay! And it's saying your order is gonna be here. What was it? Tuesday, by the end of the day. And I was like, sweet, that's amazing. I'm so excited for that, right? As one is when you get your thing you ordered. So Tuesday comes and I'm like, well, it doesn't even say that it's in Washington. So I'm going to go with no, but it didn't say, it didn't update. So then Wednesday came and it did not update. I am doing this completely wrong. And so then, yeah, so Wednesday came, didn't update. And then it said, it's still on time, but it's going to arrive late. And I'm like, no, that's not what that means. Like, you can't still arrive on time, but arrive late. So Thursday came and finally it said it was in Washington, but it's not at my local, you know, office, obviously. And so it's like, well, it's going to be late. Like, well, yeah, no kidding, right? But it didn't give me an update. Then it said, oh yeah, no, it should be here Friday by the end of the day. And I'm like, will it? That's interesting. Since it's in Seattle, which is not where I live. I don't live in Seattle. And it still had like four more steps before it could say it was even out for delivery. So yesterday, it should be here by, you know, 9 p.m. I'm like, no. So then Friday. Oh yeah, Friday by the end of the day. And I'm like, again, it still says it's in Seattle, which, you know, maybe, you know, they didn't scan it and it didn't get updated. I mean, that can happen. So I was holding out hope, but no. So today is Saturday when I am filming this, and it says right now that it's going to be delivered by the end of today, but it does not say that it has been, processed or anything. It said that it's arrived at a post office near me, but it hasn't been scanned, sorted. It does not say it's out for delivery, but it's going to be out for delivery. It's like, dude, it's 1 o'clock already. So, and then I just saw the mail lady go by like maybe 20 minutes ago, and she did not have a box that a canvas would be in. And I don't think that Bella would send a replacement canvas all, you know, folded up and crunched up. I mean, maybe, but I'm going to go with no. So yeah, I'm a little frustrated, honestly, because I really wanted to do that for Mermaids and Magic. And, you know, I know things happen, but it's still kind of frustrating. Because now I'm like, well, there's other canvases that I'm going to end up getting that I'm going to want to do. But I have that canvas already kitted up. So I feel like I should do it. So, you know, I don't have something, you know, kitted up just sitting around. But at least while I haven't been working on that, I did get to finish Layers of Ocean Magic, which I need to do a kit down, which I'm hoping to do this weekend. And I'm almost done with, so many random loose diamonds. I don't know if that's supposed to be there or not, but I'm just taking it off. Trinity of Peace. I literally have a tiny little sliver done, like that needs to be done left. So I am hoping I can maybe finish that this weekend. Then I can kit that down. Then I have two Elizabeth Ward trays empty that I can kit something up in. Because I would like to do the Care Bear diamond painting from Art and Soul. I would like to put that in Elizabeth Ward's because I think the colors are going to be amazing and I want to see the amazing, colorful, Care Bear-y, rainbowy goodness. And then the Jaded Gem Shop is a big boy. So I think I may use a 70 bottle case, like, because I have a 70 bottle and then I have a bunch of the Art Dot, the 60 and the 120s. And so I think there's 68 colors in the J.J. Gem Shop. So if I use the 70 bottle, then I can have at least some of every color in one layer, and then I could put the rest of the diamonds in one of the 120s, because it's gonna have a lot of diamonds because it's 180 centimeters long. So it's gonna be a big boy. But let's push that so we know we finished it. And this is where I am going to leave us off. Oh my gosh, sorry. I need a little drink. That is it for today. I finished. Let's see, what did I finish? Jack nothing? Nope, 294 stitches. Well, you know what? It's better than none, which is what I've done over the last 2 months. So I'm going to take that as a win. And if you have not, fill out the Google Doc to get your Pippy the Crafty Peep sticker. If you want to get your own set of Pippy release papers, you can order them from Bee's Crafty Corner. Information will be in the box below. Also, a link for my Facebook group. If you want to join that crazy party, it's, you know, I mean, I think it's pretty cool, but I'm also biased. So, you know, take that if you want. And I need to go put a load of clothes in. So I will see you guys next time. Big awkward hugs.